Hi and welcome to this video on the new UVC to NDI adapter from Obsbot. My name's Cade Hannon and I'm a director and producer at Steamroller Productions. We are a media production company based in London, UK, focusing on event filming, marketing and promotional videos, photography and live streaming. Just a quick disclaimer that Obsbot have sent me this adapter for review and for unboxing and having a look and giving my own impressions on it, and Obsbot have not told me what to say. I kickstarted the Tiny 2 when it was on when they were fundraising it, so that's over a year ago, and that was my first introduction to Obsbot. I didn't know them, I never heard of them. So that was the first time, and I saw this Kickstarter, I thought, wow, that's amazing. Let me do it. And the camera blew me away. It's absolutely brilliant. For such a small thing, so powerful. So I really was impressed by that. And because of that, I kept an eye on them and were following what they were doing. I was really fortunate enough to get my hands on the tail airs, and so I think they're an incredible cameras, and for the price, absolutely brilliant. I have three of them and I generally take at least one with me on any job because they are so versatile and the quality is amazing, and you can just use them and stick them anywhere you want, and they're great. The adapter comes in a nice little box. It has the Obsbot logo with a picture of the adapter. There's nothing on the sides of the box, and on the back we have the description with some information on what the box contains. And inside you'll have the UVC to NDI adapter, a USB-C cable, a USB-C to USB-A adapter, so if you don't have a USB-C port on your computer, you can use this to convert it to USB-A. And of course, the user guide and a warranty card. The adapter itself seems to be really well made and quite robust. On the front, it has the Obsbot logo with the tally light. At the top, it has ventilation holes to keep it nice and cool, and a 1/4-inch socket for mounting to a tripod. Or accessories, or whatever you want to attach to it or put it on. On the bottom, it has the same as the top, so the same ventilation holes and the same 1/4-inch as the top. Now, on the right side, we have the micro SD slot for recording, and then the NDI and PoE port to connect to the router. PoE, of course, is power over Ethernet. On the left side, we have the USB-C port for charging the adapter, a USB-A port for connecting a remote control USB, such as the one that comes with the Tiny 2 camera. And then finally, we have the USB-C port to plug the UVC camera into. And you can have a look at different other cameras, not just the Tiny 2, to see if those work. And of course, we'll be looking at that. And I bet Obsbot are going to have perhaps compatible cameras as well on their website. If we compare the adapter to a Tiny 2 camera, of course, the Tiny 2 camera is tiny. That's why it's called that, but it's really small. So, and then, of course, next to a tail air camera, the adapter is quite a lot smaller than that. If you look at it that way too. So yeah, size wise, good size, fits anywhere, fits everywhere. So really can easily go into a bag for if you need it at a job. Yeah, so that is the first impressions and the unboxing of the adapter. I'll do another video later on going into more details of the actual adapter and what I thought of it and how maybe we can use it in different situations and workflows. But really, it's a really well-made product, and like I said, really strong, robust, looks really, really, really nice as well. It's a nice color. It doesn't actually, you know, can't see any fingerprints on it, which is also great. Doesn't attract fingerprints. So yeah, really looking forward to getting into this adapter, and I'll do another video later on, which is all about how to use it and how I've tested it and any thoughts on it as well. So for now, thanks for watching and have a fantastic day.